yesterday's class continuation. You just leave a few pages so that you have the topic complete with you, and then I'll start. I'll just tell you the number of pages you have to leave. I think I stopped at 243 J Gada. Okay, leave about one full page and take down AP Reorganization Act. Leave about one full page. And take down AP Reorganization Act. Okay, now firstly, what kind of questions you will get on this? AP Reorganization Act, you have to remember the approach will be this. You should, there are parts, schedules and sections in each part. For example, which section deals with common governor, which section tells that the common governor will have special responsibilities for the common capital. So section, which schedule deals with list of industries, which schedule deals with list of government funds, okay, which part deals with what. So we are going to approach this in this manner, where I'm going to go part wise, schedule wise and section wise. Sections will be found within parts. The way you have articles in constitution inside parts, you will have sections in the parts. So just make a note of this and then we'll start. Now, we just go back and we take down a few dates. When was it approved by Lok Sabha, Rajya Sabha? When was it rejected by the AP State Assembly? Abiraskunmund. Take down. Andhra Pradesh Assembly. Returned the AP Reorganization Bill. Without approval on 30th January, approval on 30th January 2014. Please remember, the AP Assembly did not reject it. In fact, moved another resolution opposing the reorganization bill. Take down the second one. Lok Sabha approved it on February 18th. On February 18th, Rajya Sabha on February 20th. Assented by the President on March 1st. And published in the official gazette on 2nd June and published in the official gazette on 2nd June, sorry, 1st March, 2nd March, sorry, on 2nd March. Take down the next, appointment day, 2nd June 2014. Now, what do you mean by appointment day? The day in a new state was created. Appointment day, 2nd June 2014. Now, take down. The AP Reorganization Act has 12 Reorganization Act has 12 parts and 13 schedules, 12 parts and 13 schedules, 12 parts and 13 schedules. Okay, 12 parts and 13 schedules. First, let's finish with the schedules. Put the heading as Schedules of the Act. Schedules of the Act. Schedule 1. Schedule 1. Deals with representation of members in the Rajya Sabha, representation of members in the Rajya Sabha from AP and Telangana. From AP and Telangana. Okay, now write down. Rajya Sabha, the division goes like this. 11 members from AP, 7 from TS. Total strength of United AP was 18. So just make a note of that. And in this, they basically tell us who are these 11 members, the names of these 11 members who are allocated under AP and when do they retire by? Because Rajya Sabha, every one third will retire after how many years? 2 years. So they also specify the names of the members and their tenure. Details are given under Schedule 1. Make a note of it. Names and tenure. Below that, please write down section 12 of part 3, please underline section 12 of part 3, deals with amendment to the 4th schedule of the constitution, amendment to the 4th schedule of the constitution. And states that 11 seats are allocated. States that 11 seats are allocated to AP and 7 to TS. The point here is section 12 will tell you about this allocation. This part, the names and when do they retire, is given under Schedule 1. Are you clear? This part, how much is allocated, is given under section 12. Which part? Part 3. Okay, but who will be the members and when will they retire? Their tenure is given under Schedule 1. Okay, now take down Schedule 2. Deals with delimitation of constituencies in the Lok Sabha and the State Legislative Assembly. In the Lok Sabha and State Legislative Assembly. Now here again, section 14 will tell you how many seats are allocated to AP and TS. Then what will Schedule 2 tell you? Schedule 2 will tell you how many seats. Delimitation deals with what all? What is delimitation? Quick. Delimitation is how many constituencies per state? What is delimitation? Territorial boundaries of constituencies. What all can be recommended in the name of delimitation? Aim hai mosta hai delimitation kinda. ఏమేం రికమెండ్ చేయొచ్చు? హౌ మెనీ సీట్స్ పర్ స్టేట్? ఇంకా వాట్ విల్ బీ ద టెరిటోరియల్ బౌండరీస్ ఆఫ్ ఈచ్ కాన్స్టిట్యుయెన్సీ? ఇంకొకటి రిజర్వేషన్ ఫర్ ఎస్సీస్ అండ్ ఎస్టీ. సో ఇన్ దిస్ షెడ్యూల్ దే విల్ బేసికలీ టెల్ అస్ హౌ మెనీ సీట్స్ విల్ బి రిజర్వ్డ్ ఫార్ ఎస్సీస్ అండ్ ఎస్టీస్. ఓకే, హౌ మెనీ సీట్స్ ఫర్ ద స్టేట్స్ ఇస్ గివెన్ అండర్ సెక్షన్ 14. హౌ మెనీ సీట్స్ రిజర్వేషన్ ఫర్ ఎస్సీస్ అండ్ ఎస్టీస్ విల్ బి అండర్ సెక్షన్ షెడ్యూల్ 2. రైట్ డౌన్ సెక్షన్ 14. సెక్షన్ 14 ఆఫ్ పార్ట్ 3. సెక్షన్ 14 ఆఫ్ పార్ట్ 3 స్టేట్స్ దాట్ అవుట్ ఆఫ్ ద టోటల్ 42 సీట్స్ హౌ మెనీ ఆర్ ఎలకేటెడ్? What is the division? 42 seats. AP gets how many? 25. And TS gets 17. Make a note of this. Now, within this AP, we continue the flowchart. 4 seats will be for SC and 2 seats will be reserved for ST. Okay, within TS, 3 for SC and 2 for ST. Continue and finish it off. Write down, this is given where? Under which section? 14. And this is given where? Under Schedule 2. Mark it clearly, separately. Finish, take down. Section 17 of part 3. Section 17 of part 3 deals with the allocation of seats. Deals with the allocation of seats in the state legislative assemblies. In the state legislative assembly to AP and TS. Now tell me, what is the allocation? Out of the total 294, how many seats are for AP? 175, and TS is 119. Out of this again SC, ST. SC is 29, ST is 7. This is immaterial for you anyways, but make a note. SC is 19 and ST is 12. In numbers, chala 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 important. You might get, and remember, these are reserved constituencies. They are not the actual representation of SCs and STs. Reserved constituencies will be less than the actual representation. Why? Because they contest from open category also. Okay, so actual number will always be greater than the reserved number, right? Now this part is given where? It is given under schedule. And what about this part? Under section 17 of part Finished? Now take down. The second schedule also gives, write down, the second schedule also gives the list of, also gives the list of parliamentary constituencies and state legislative assembly constituencies, state legislative assembly constituencies, legislative assembly constituencies in both AP and TS. It gives you the list of all constituencies including the mandals in that constituency. Okay. Now take down third schedule, schedule 3. Gives, write down, schedule 3 gives the list of constituencies in the state legislative council, list of constituencies in the state legislative council of the two states. What is the meaning of this? Now, how are seats allocated in the state legislative council? Yes, what is the basis for allocating seats in state legislative council? It is group based constituencies, antena. Group based, where you have representation from teachers, graduates, inka local authorities, inka MLA's constituencies, isn't it? Now, this schedule will basically tell you how many teachers' constituencies, how many graduates, local authority and MLA. They give you the number and the territory from there where you are representing. For example, when you say local authority constituency, which all territories will elect the local authority constituency members. So basically, they'll give you the number for teachers, graduates, local authorities and MLAs. Make a note of that. Below, please write down. It also gives the list of, it also gives of the list of, write down. It also gives the list of the names of members, the names of members, names of members representing each of these constituencies, each of these constituencies, names of members representing each of these constituencies. For example, I'm sure you all know Chukka Ramayya. Yes, he represented whose constituency? He was a MLC. You are aware of it? Dr. Nageshwar Rao, prominent journalist and professor. Yes, he teaches. He is also a member of the council. From which constituency? Which of these constituencies? Teachers' constituency, I know. Ramayya is from graduates' constituency. So they give graduates' constituency name, teachers' constituency names. Okay, now moving on. The fifth schedule. Fifth schedule. This point is fourth schedule. Mir raaskuna point fourth schedule. Adi kada, ma third correcte. Ippudu raasaru kada, it also gives the list. Adi fourth schedule. also cut jayandi, please cut the word also, write down. Take down the next one, the fifth schedule. Write down. It gives the list of the scheduled, it gives the list of the scheduled costs identified in the Telangana state, in the Telangana state. Okay, it is not listing the AP scheduled caste because it is already identified. United AP lo unna list continues for AP, the new AP. Telangana has a new list of scheduled caste. Take down the next one. The sixth schedule gives the list of communities. List of communities identified as scheduled tribes in the state of Telangana. Okay, AP list will not be given. The reason it will not be given is United AP list continues for the new state of AP. So you only have the list of TS there. Take down the next one. Seventh schedule is very, very important. Please mark it important. List of funds. Now write down. This schedule lists the funds held by the United AP. Okay, full stop and continue. It has 69 funds listed. 69 number is important. Please underline 69 funds listed. Ante meaning entante, you have various funds. For example, you have provident fund. It is held by the state government. It is provident fund is for the United AP. Now when you are dividing AP into two parts, TS and AP, you should also decide what are you going to do with this fund which is held by United AP. What will be done with these funds is given under section 52. Okay. List of how many funds are actually there is given under schedule 7. So schedule 7 is only going to tell you what are the names of those funds which are held by the United AP. But how are you going to divide these funds between TS and AP will be given under section 52. Just make a note of this, write down section 52 of part 6 deals with the clauses related to sharing and distribution of these funds. Okay, now write down. According to section 52, all funds listed in Schedule 7 will be divided will be divided between the two states on the basis of population. Please underline, on the basis of population. On the basis of population. Now remember, whenever we talk about a division of anything between AP and TS, there are two ways in which they have divided. One basis, that basis for division, generally speaking, I'm telling you, for division when you're preparing, you have to list this separately. Basis for division is two. One is on the basis of population percentage, okay? The other is on the basis of territory. For example, if it is located in territory of AP, it is given to AP. If it is located in territory of Telangana, it will be given to Telangana. So please remember, basis for all divisions under the AP Reorganization Act will be either population or territory. Maximum of them is population. Okay, majority of it will be population. Now take down. However, the investments in the calamity relief fund, the investments continue. However, the investments in the calamity relief fund is important. Please underline calamity relief fund. However, the investments in the calamity relief fund will be divided between the two states on the basis of the area, on the basis of the area in the two states. Okay, now the meaning is simple. Look at the board. For all funds, what will be the basis? You have 69 funds. For all these funds, the basis will be population percentage, except one fund. What is that one fund? Calamity relief fund. The basis will be territory, depending on the percentage of territory. How much percentage of territory AP holds, that much percentage of the fund will be given to AP. Only for this it is going to be territory based. Rest of the funds, it is going to be population based. Now make a note of this. Okay, now take down schedule 8, 8th schedule. 8th schedule, 69 rao, nen maamulga rasna 68 ostai ikkada, kan 68 kuda raadu, endukante calamity relief fund is not a single fund. All those funds which are basically for calamity relief will be on the basis of territory. So meeku exam lo adiginappudu rendu questions, okatemo how many funds are listed under schedule 7. Second will be, what is the section which deals with distribution of funds listed in schedule 7. Third will be, which is the only fund under schedule 7 which will be divided on the basis of territory. So don't bother about how many are given here. You have to remember the name. Ardhamainda? This is how the question will be asked. Schedule 8 deals with apportionment of liabilities, apportionment of liabilities in respect of pensions. Apportionment of liabilities in respect of pensions. Okay, now what do you mean by this? With respect to pensions to be given to retired employees and existing employees, how is it divided? The division is very simple. To put it, it says till the appointed day. What is the appointed day? 2nd June 2014. Now till the appointed day. We will talk about before and till the appointed day, and we will talk about after the appointed day. Before and till the appointed day, whoever retires, their pension will be the responsibility of AP. Okay, whoever retires after the appointment day, the pension will be the responsibility of the successive states. Ante, if they retire from the state of AP, AP should pay. If they retire from the state of TS, TS should pay. This is a very important point because it is one of those major challenges in under the bifurcation for AP. Irrespective of where they served, irrespective of which region, if they retire before or till 2nd June 2014, the responsibility of paying pensions will lie on AP. Okay, clear with this? Make a note of this now. Finished? Below that please write down section 59 of part 6 deals with pensions and states that pensions payment will be divided between the two states, will be divided between the two states on the basis of the arrangement, on the basis of the arrangement given under, on the basis of the arrangement given under Schedule 8. Arrangement given under Schedule 8. Okay, so it basically tells us that Schedule 8, they will tell us how this will be decided, and the decision is very, very simple. Anything before till to 2nd June will be the responsibility of AP. So whoever retired before 2nd June, till they get the pension, they should be paid pension from AP, and whoever retires after, depending on where they are allocated, their pension will be paid. Now take down Schedule 9. Schedule 9 gives a list of garment companies and corporations with their address. Schedule 9 is important, mark it important, underline government companies and corporations and write down. The schedule contains a list of 89 companies and corporations. 89 companies and corporations. Now, how do you divide them? It says that wherever they are existing, the territory-based division, it is going to be territory-based division. If they are established in AP, they will continue to function for AP, and the same board will be newly constituted for TS. So, as far as companies and corporations are concerned, it is going to be territory based division. Make a note of that. Section 68 of Part 7. States that these companies and corporations will continue to function. These companies and corporations will continue to function in the areas they are located. And shall continue to function under the state government of the state where they are based. Tenth schedule. Write down. Gives the list of training institutions and centers in the United AP. The schedule contains a list of 107 institutions. Number is important. The schedule contains a list of 107 institutions. Now take down Section 75 of Part 7. Deals with the functioning of the institutions mentioned under Schedule 10. We'll stop and continue. It states that these institutions shall work under the state government, shall continue to work under the state government in the state where they are located. Full stop and continue. However, these institutions shall continue to provide facilities shall continue to provide facilities to the people of other states, to the people of other states, other states, for such period as agreed upon by the two state governments, as agreed upon by the two state governments. Now, what do you mean by this? It simply means that all institutions, the supervision of these institutions, functioning of these institutions will be the responsibility of the concerned state government. So if they are located in Telangana, it will be the responsibility of Telangana state. If it is AP, it will be the responsibility of AP. However, who will get admitted or who can avail the services of these institutions? Tell me, who will avail the services of these institutions? People from both the states, meaning you cannot deny admission of one person, of a person belonging to a particular state in another state. You should continue to provide them services until the time period decided by, who fixes this time period? Fixed by both the governments. So both governments agree on a particular time frame. They fix that time frame. Until then, they will allow admissions of people from each state in these institutions. Make a note of this. Finished. Now take down schedule 11 deals with the principles governing the functioning of river management boards. Okay, write down this schedule. Gives details related to the provisions of Section 85. Details related to the provisions of Section 85 of Part 9, which deals with the constitution and functions of river management board. Okay. Now, basically, one of the major issues that was highlighted during the bifurcation of AP was the river water disputes that might arise. Now, what is the alternative provided by the AP Reorganization Act in order to resolve these disputes? Yes? With regard to river water disputes, there are three things which are clearly mentioned in the Reorganization Act. The first it says is whatever award has been given by the tribunals, award of water will be binding on AP and TS. So the first is it settles that whatever allocation has been made by the tribunals, it will be binding on AP and TS on the set date. Second, it says in order to avoid future problems, we will appoint an apex council. This council will be responsible for the supervision